This is Shane, a smart IBO. While out for lunch one day, he meets Sarah, one of his customers. Sarah is glad to meet Shane, and she wants to talk to him about a particular Amway food supplement product. Shane happily outlines the features and benefits of the supplement to Sarah. Sarah seems to be interested, but she still has many questions. After inquiring about the product in detail, Sarah is still thinking if the cost justifies the benefits of the supplement. Shane senses that he is close to making the sale. He quickly thinks of an idea to convince Sarah. Shane tells his sister's experience concerning the supplement. My sister had problems her whole life. She was always itchy and prone to rashes. She also had a chronic cough whenever the weather would turn cold. But when she started taking these, within just a couple of months, her skin problems went away. And a few months after that, she stopped coughing. My sister will tell you she is never going to stop taking them. After hearing the real-life story, Sarah immediately agrees to purchase the supplement. Shane is highly satisfied with the tough sale he's made. A few months later, Sarah called Shane and complains about the product that he sold to her. She tells Shane that she has been taking this supplement for months, but it hasn't cured any of her ailments. Sarah is totally dissatisfied and very unhappy with the product and with Shane. What rules were broken? What harm resulted? Let's explore. Shane told a story about the product from his sister's personal experience, creating a specific expectation in the customer, rather than sticking to published claims and scientific research from Amway. Shane's claim that the supplement was responsible for his sister's improvement was not supported by scientifically validated proof. Even if his sister did get better, there was no substantiating evidence that it was a result of the supplement. Shane's approach to sell the product resulted in loss of faith in the product, in Shane, and probably in Amway. While trying to sell or promote an Amway product, IBOs must abide by these rules of conduct relating to product claims. Amway products must be accurately represented, which protects the company's reputation and benefits all IBOs. IBOs in Amway are protected from exposure to unnecessary legal or regulatory risk when IBOs stick to Amway's published claims. When customers hear accurate information about Amway products, this builds trust, results in stronger relationships, increases sales over time, and helps IBOs build more profitable and sustainable businesses. It is important to keep in mind that making unsupported claims has potential risks to customers' health and well-being, as well as serious legal and ethical implications. IBOs are not placed at a competitive disadvantage when the claims of other IBOs are consistent with Amway's published statements. Teaching customers correctly about Amway products is at the heart of the selling process and distinguishes Amway from many other producers in the marketplace. IBOs must stick to Amway's published claims because they contain the truth about Amway products. Ultimately, nothing is better for you or your Amway business than the truth.